Let's set up a relationship between the variables x and y. So let's say, so this is x and this is y. And when x is 1, y is 4. And when x is 2, y is 8. And when x is 3, y is 12. Now you might immediately recognize that this is a proportional relationship. And remember, in order for it to be a proportional relationship, the ratio between the two variables is always constant. So for example, if I look at y over x here, we see that y over x here, it's 4 over 1, which is just 4. 8 over 2 is just 4. 8 halves is the same thing as 4. 12 over 3 is the same thing as 4. Y over x is always equal to 4. In fact, I can make another column here. I can make another column here where I have y over x. Here it's 4 over 1. Which is equal to 4. Here it's 8 over 2, which is equal to 4. Here it's 12 over 3, which is equal to 4. And so you can actually use this information, the ratio between y and x is this constant 4, to express the relationship between y and x as an equation. In fact, in some ways this is, or in a lot of ways, this is already an equation, but I can make it a little bit clearer if I multiply both sides by x. If I multiply both sides by x, I am left with, well, x divided by x, you just have y on the left-hand side. Y is equal to 4x. And you see that's the case. X is 1, 4 times that is 4. X is 2, 4 times that is 8. So here you go. We're multiplying by 4. We are multiplying by 4. We are multiplying by 4. And so 4 in this case, in this situation, this is our constant of proportionality. Constant. Sometimes people will say proportionality constant. Constant of proportionality. Proportionality. Now sometimes it might even be described as a rate of change. And you're like, well, Sal, how would 4 be a rate of change? And to make that a little bit clearer, let me actually do another example, but this time I'll actually put some units there. So let's say that x, let me use blue. So let's say that's a measure of time, and y is a measure of distance. Or let me put it this way. X is time in terms of seconds. Let me write it this way. So x is going to be in seconds. And then y is going to be in meters. So this is meters, the units, and this right over here is seconds. So after 1 second, we have traveled, 7 meters. After 2 seconds, we've traveled 14 meters. After 3 seconds, we've traveled 21 meters. And you can verify that this is a proportional relationship. The ratio between y and x is always 7. 7 over 1, 14 over 2, 21 over 3. But I want to write that in terms of its units. So y over x is going to be, if we look at this point right over here, it's 7 meters over 1 second. 7 meters over 1 second, or it's equal to 7 meters per second. If you look at it right over here, if you say y over x, it's 14 meters in 2 seconds. In 2 seconds, well, 14 over 2 is 7. 14 over 2 is 7, and then the units are meters per second. So that's why this constant, the 7, in all of these cases, we have y over x is equal to 7, that this is also sometimes considered a rate. And over here it's very clear, this is my distance per time. Now if I wanted to write it generally, I could say that, look, if I'm dealing with a proportional relationship, it's going to be of the form, I can always construct an equation of the form either y over x is equal to k, where k is some constant. In this first example, k was equal to 4. In this second example, k is equal to 7. Or you can just manipulate it algebraically, multiply both sides by x, and you would have y is equal to kx, where once again, k is our constant of proportionality, or proportionality constant. So this is a really, in some ways, it's a very simple idea, but in a lot of ways, you'll see this showing up many times in your mathematical career. It's neat to be able to recognize this as a proportional relationship.